Hey, hopefully you guys are having an amazing day. Welcome back to another Most Amazing Top 10 video. I'm your host for today, Landon Do Not Sing, and today we're gonna be talking about the top 10 scary Bloody Mary urban legends, and a lot of these freak me out. The research for this, yeah, there's a lot on it and a lot of stories out there. So before we get into this creepy list, I'm just letting you guys know, stay tuned to the end of this video because I'm gonna be answering you guys' comments from previous videos. It's been a whole lot of fun and it's a good way to engage with you guys. It's something we've been missing. Okay, so enough of all that, let's talk about Bloody Mary, the reason why you came here. This urban legend has been around for hundreds of years, and people who are equally brave and stupid have been trying to summon her to see if she actually exists. And I remember the first time I tried to summon her, I think I was 8 or 9, I freaked myself out, I freaked my sister out, my sister is mortified of it, I can't turn off the lights on her anymore because she thinks Bloody Mary, we summoned her when we were kids and she's gonna come out every single time, but all you do is you turn off the lights and say Bloody Mary 3 times. And then, yeah, I wouldn't recommend it because you're not gonna sleep. I haven't slept for like 20 years. So this can go horribly wrong if you guys successfully summon her spirit, and I think we did. So by saying Bloody Mary 3 times in front of a mirror with a lit candle, well, this is how you summon her in, you know, the popular version of it. But in different places around the world, you can summon Bloody Mary in different rituals. So let's get right into this cursed list and take a look at the top 10 scary Bloody Mary urban legends. Alright, so we'll start off with this creepy list, and at number 10, with the girl who refused to talk about her Bloody Mary experience. I know for me, I didn't want to talk about it for a long time. I couldn't believe what I saw. One night at a slumber party, all of the girls dared one of them to go into the bathroom and call out Bloody Mary's name 3 times. The friend accepted this dare, but she was also so terrified to death. After 15 minutes had passed, they heard the poor girl scream, and she was struggling to open the door. When her friends finally got the door open, the girl in the washroom was whimpering, shaking, and crying for help. Her arms were covered in bruises and cuts, and even to this day, she apparently refuses to talk about what happened in that bathroom. Classic Bloody Mary scares us in at number 9. 3 friends were hanging out on Friday the 13th. This is the day I would not summon her. So they were talking about urban legends, especially Bloody Mary. So they all convinced one another to try the ritual for themselves. The 3 of them gathered candles, went into a pitch black bathroom, and waited until 2:55 a.m. They chanted Bloody Mary 13 times, and all of a sudden they saw a swirl of smoke and a figure of an old woman that appeared in the mirror. All 3 girls instantly screamed, turned on the lights, and Bloody Mary vanished, but that doesn't mean that they're safe. Now, in at number 8, we have Queen Mary the First. The origins of Bloody Mary varies from country to country, but the most popular theory is that Queen Mary is the spirit of Bloody Mary, because during her reign as queen, during the Tudor period, she was nicknamed Bloody Mary because she had an unusual amount of miscarriages, and she was also very quick to order executions during her 5 years as Queen of England. So yes, there was a true story behind Bloody Mary. In some versions of Bloody Mary, the person is supposed to chant her name 3 times, and then you're actually supposed to say, I stole your baby, or I killed your baby. When I was 10, I didn't know that was a thing, so maybe I summoned something else? This is pretty awful for kids trying in the bathroom. The mirror that cracked pierces its way into number 7. A group of girls at a summer camp thought it would be fun to summon Bloody Mary. Personally, this isn't my idea of a good time, but that's just me. So these girls ran into a dark bathroom and they chanted her name 3 times. At first, nothing happened, so the girls were mocking Bloody Mary, but then the mirror began to violently crack and all of the girls ran outside of the bathroom except for one, because she was just so paralyzed with fear. It happens, you're so afraid you just can't move. Well, when she was alone with Bloody Mary in the bathroom, she saw a flash of movement in the mirror as if someone was standing right beside her. Eventually, she was able to get up and run for her life. Now, next morning, they laughed about the incident, but they all vowed to never attempt to summon her ever again. Alright, number 6, the Japanese version of Bloody Mary. Different regions and cultures may have their own versions of Bloody Mary, and this is the urban legend that is haunting Japan. According to the legend, if someone goes into the 3rd stall of the girl's bathroom on the 3rd floor of a school, then knocks 3 times and asks, "Are you there?" the spirit will answer, I am here. If I hear that, I would be freaking out. And then if you choose to enter the stall, there will be a small girl wearing a red skirt waiting for you. Is this real life right now? What is going on in Japan? Some people have claimed that after summoning her, Haku-san's bloody hand can be seen from under the door. Some people have even said that if you enter the stall, you'll be eaten by a three-headed lizard. I don't know about you guys, but I'm gonna stay away from, you know, the third stall on the third floor in a school. Dead silence brings us to number 5. Two friends just finished watching a horror movie, and one of their friends wanted to scare the other one. So she took her friend into a bathroom and chanted Bloody Mary 3 times and waited for her to appear. After a couple of minutes, she disappeared and decided to turn on the lights when all of a sudden she saw a third reflection in the mirror. When she looked closer, she saw a black and white woman with her mouth wide open. This sent shivers down their spines because they were expecting that this figure would like start screaming because why is her mouth open? However, this creepy spirit remained silent and began to lift up her arms. Her hands were drenched in blood and her fingernails were actually torn off. Bloody Mary reached for the girls and touched one of them on the shoulders. The two girls desperately screamed for help, turned on all the lights, and ran for their lives. Well, I guess it's safe to say that these two are never going to attempt to summon Bloody Mary ever again or use that bathroom. In fact, I would never use any bathroom again. Bloody Mary with cuts on her face slices in at number 4. During a sleepover, 9-year-old Katie and her friends decided that they wanted to have a little fun, so they tried to summon Bloody Mary. They all brought candles into the bathroom, turned out all the lights, and began chanting her name, Bloody Mary. Bloody Mary. And then when they saw an old woman with cuts and scrapes all over her wrinkled face, she also had chains tightly looped around her neck and shoulders. The girls were so frightened, they all began to scream, and suddenly the shower curtains burst into flames. They all ran out of the bathroom, and her older brother was the one who put out the fire. These girls were blamed for the fire, but they all know what the truth was that night. It was Bloody Mary. The possession comes into number 3. When Amanda was only 12 years old, she attempted to summon Bloody Mary, and ever since that night, she believes that Bloody Mary's spirit opened up a portal that allowed demons and ghosts to enter into her soul. As she grew up, she believes that she was possessed by demons, so she became addicted to drugs, she suffered from psychosis, and was even institutionalized for a month. Amanda has even attempted to perform many exorcisms without any success, so now lots of people believe that if you attempt the Bloody Mary ritual, you are opening up a portal for demonic spirits that can really harm you. So, listening to that, I don't know what I did as a 10-year-old, but did I just open up a portal? Moving into number 2, we have the red reflection. Lauren and her friend were driving one night, and they started talking about the scariest urban legends. Bloody Mary came up, and they thought it would be cool to see if this urban legends was true or not. So they pulled over and went inside a gas station bathroom. They turned off the lights, splashed water on the mirror, spun around and chanted Bloody Mary, Bloody Mary, Bloody Mary. When these girls looked into the mirror, they discovered that one of the reflections began to turn red. They kept staring at the reflection for a couple more minutes, and then they ran out of the bathroom in fear, fear for their life. Once they were far enough, they realized that one friend's face was covered in blood, and once they cleaned it up, she had tiny scratch marks all over her face. Finally, in a number 1 spot, we have the boy who died performing a Bloody Mary ritual. This is definitely the worst case scenario when attempting to summon this evil spirit, and although this might just be an urban legend, it's still enough for me to not want to attempt to summon her, you know, ever again, because I've already done it when I was 10. This urban legend focuses around two friends who wanted to provoke Bloody Mary. They summoned her by writing 666 on the mirror with red lipstick. They lit some candles, and only one of them stayed in the bathroom because they thought it wouldn't work if there was, you know, more than one person inside. After he chanted her cursed name, the candles went out, the door was locked, and the friend couldn't get into the bathroom to save him. After 15 minutes of trying to break in, he finally got in and he saw his friend's lifeless body resting on the sink. Not sure what happened, but he died. Well, there you guys have it. What a brutal way to end this video. We just ended on a death. Why did I do that? Well, it is time to reply to your guys' comments from previous videos. So first up, we have Super Spy Todd. Will you do a fan mail? We used to do fan mail back in the day. It was pretty successful. Not sure why we stopped, but yes, the answer is yes. We're gonna be starting it up very soon. Olfell says, how long have you guys been doing YouTube? I've been doing YouTube personally for about 8 years now. I think Rebecca and Danny have been doing it for about maybe 3 years, maybe 4 years. listeners. Anna Steele says, if you were stuck in a horror situation, would you rather be home alone or hearing screaming in the woods? I think I'd rather be home alone because I'd rather die in comfort and warmness instead of a forest, wooded area. And at least people can find my body that way. Cass said, $1 million question. Is this real life right now? If you guys can answer that, I'll give you $1 million. Brad Mining said, are you guys going to still do discontinued food on Most Amazing Top 10? The answer is, I don't know. We've done a lot of foods. Maybe put some suggestions in the comment section below, but I think we've done it all. Aiden House says, oh my gosh, love this channel. Thank you so much. Thank you to every single person who has subscribed here. We are on the road to 4 million subscribers. Can we do it? Venice Vlog says, tour. We just did the Toronto fan meetup. And it was a massive success. It was a huge success, a lot of fun. And we're thinking of doing a few more places. So stay tuned for big announcements. The next comment says, I would be at the meet, but I'm in Africa. Which part of Africa are you from? I recently traveled to South Africa. It was an amazing place, but you never know. Maybe Most Amazing does Africa. Next up, we have Definitely Come Do a Tour in Minneapolis. It's for sure a possibility. This channel is becoming one of my favorites, so keep it up. Keep up the good work. I like how I just paraphrased it. Thank you so much, buddy. Next up, we have Eyes Lit Up. Love you, Landon. Hashtag fave host. All hail King Landon. Why are you guys trying to butter me up here? Please do a top 10 scary videos. Well, I think we just did that.